Yeah, good evening, students. Nice to meet you all after a long break. I thank Gaikwad sir, Suman sir, Vipin sir, Priyanka madam for providing us an opportunity to interact with the student during the lockdown. Dear students, stay home, stay safe. Follow the norms given by our Honorable Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi ji. Observe all the precaution, wear the mask as you are at home. You are expected to study, to do yoga, to help your mother. Please don't waste your time. Utilize your time in developing and learning new skills. So I will be today starting with the accounts part, and today I will be discussing with you the syllabus of your bookkeeping and accountancy, or as well as the paper pattern. Your syllabus this year has undergone change. One topic, previously single entry system, which was in 12th class, has already been shifted in the 11th class. You all have studied it in the 11th class, and a new topic, computer accounting, has been introduced. So this is the change in your syllabus. One by one, I will take you to the contents of your syllabus, starting with the first topic is introduction to partnership and partnership final account. In this, in partnership and partnership final account, just a minute, students, accounts book. I have sent accounts book on your WhatsApp group. This is a revised new syllabus 2020 book. The student can refer to this book. I will be using this book for the teaching purpose. Yes, the first is introduction to partnership and partnership final account. So in this chapter, we will understand what does partnership mean and what are the features of partnership. It is governed by the Indian Partnership Act 1932. Then we will study what is partnership deed. It is an agreement amongst the partner. I am just providing you the brief contents of the chapter. Detail we will study when we go ahead with the chapter. Then after understanding partnership deed, we will see the what are the contents of the partnership deed. Then the partner's capital account, in what way and in what form the partners maintain their capital account. There are two methods. We will study those methods in detail. Then in your 11th class, you all have studied about sole proprietor chief final account. Now the final account are also here in your 11th standard, but they are partnership final account. Final account, you are very well know, comprises of three things, that is trading account, profit and loss account, and balance sheet. Balance sheet, you all know, it is not an account, it is an statement. Then while preparing the final account, various adjustments are to be done. Some of the many adjustments we have studied in 11th class. In 12th class, some more advanced adjustments would be there, and we will study them and we will learn to prepare the final account, that is trading profit and loss account and balance sheet. By preparing the final account, we come to know about the financial result, that is gross profit, net profit, and the financial position of the business. You see, student, this chapter is of immense importance. It lays down the foundation of your other chapters, like the next chapter is accounting for non-profit concern. What are not-for-profit concern? You see, Sports Club of India, Bombay Hospital, these are also organization, but the main object of this organization is not to earn profit. Their main objective is to provide services to the society. So they are called as not-for-profit concern. But these organizations also need to know their financial result, that is how much profit they have earned and what is their financial position. So in this chapter, we will learn to prepare their financial position and to prepare their income statement as well as their balance sheet. Here, like in the partnership, to know gross profit and net profit, we were preparing trading account and profit and loss account. But in case of not-for-profit organization, not-for-profit concern, we will prepare in place of trading P&L, we will prepare income and expenditure account. If the income is more, then the expenditure will get less. And if the expenditure is more, then the income, we will get deficit. And after knowing the surplus or deficit, we will prepare balance sheet. So this is also a practical oriented chapter, and a full practical question is asked from this. Next, it is the admission of the partner. You see, two partners or three partners are there in the firm. The partnership organization is running short of money. It requires additional capital, or it is running short of expertise. So they induct a new partner to provide more money or to provide the expertise. A new partner is inducted into the business, and this is known as admission of partner. When a new partner is admitted, the existing partner will give their share of profit to the incoming partner. They will sacrifice their existing share of profit. So what they are sacrificing and in what ratio they are sacrificing, it is known as sacrificing ratio. So here we will have to learn to calculate the sacrifice ratio. Then when a new partner is admitted, the existing business might have built its reputation, and the reputation of the business is known as goodwill. So what all reputation the existing partner have built up, the incoming partner will have to pay for the reputation, that is for the goodwill of the business. How much goodwill he has to bring, the money for the goodwill he has to pay, that year we will learn to calculate. Then if they are existing profit, accumulated profit, they will be distributed. The existing profit are due to the efforts of the existing partners. So they need to be paid to the, or provided to be credited to the existing partner before the new partner come in. Because after the new partner come in, he will share the reserves and surplus also. So before a new partner is admitted, the existing reserves and surplus accumulated profit are to be credited to the account of the old partners. Then the assets and liabilities, whatever assets and liabilities are there in the firm, they need to be brought down to the market value. How? This I will explain with you with the help of an example. Suppose the partnership firm has brought a land worth 1 lakh before 20 years. Now, after lapse of 20 years, this 1 lakh worth of land is now worth 1 crore of rupee. So the value of the land has appreciated by 99 lakhs. This 99 lakhs appreciation belongs to the old partner. So if it is not that this accumulated profit, this revalued profit is not given to the existing partner, new partner will be entitled to claim in the old profit. So before the admission of the new partner, the existing assets, as well as the liabilities are brought down to their market or the realizable value. So how it will be done, that we will study in this chapter. Here also, it is a practical oriented chapter, and every year 10 marks practical question come from this. Just now I have mentioned about the what does admission mean and how the process is carried out. In a similar way, if a partner wants to leave a firm, he is allowed to leave a firm after giving proper notice that now I don't want to continue, and he will leave the firm, or he will follow the procedure mentioned in the partnership deed or as per Partnership Act. After giving proper notice, he can leave the firm. Now, when he leaves the firm, what is his share of profit, it will be enjoyed by the remaining partner. So the remaining partner will gain this. They will gain in what ratio they will gain. It is known as the gain ratio. We will learn to calculate the gain ratio for the existing partner, and what all I mentioned, that the distribution of accumulated profit, it will be done to all the existing partner. The assets and liabilities will be adjusted to their market value or realizable value. Then in what way this procedure is to be carried out, that we will learn in detail in the chapter. Then the next is dissolution. Like retirement, there is death of the partner. So if a partner dies, all the procedure that I mentioned in the retirement are to be followed in the chapter of death of the partner. Now next is dissolution. Now what does dissolution mean? The dissolution means closing down the business of the firm. Pause. What dissolution? Dissolution of a firm means?
Okay.
Yes. Dissolution, I was talking about the dissolution. Dissolution of a firm means closing down the business of the firm. When the business of the firm is closed down, then the assets will be sold, so the assets will be realized. As the assets are sold, the liabilities need to be settled. They need to be paid. So we will learn the accounting treatment of all the realization of asset as well as of the settlement of liability. Here you will learn general entries, as well as ledger account. Here also it is a practical oriented chapter, and every year 10 marks question come from this chapter. However, with this chapter a choice come. Choice come with company account. Now the next is bills of exchange. What is bill of exchange? Bills of exchange. Suppose you students, you all know that in the present day the business is based on credit. Not all, only a small portion of the business is done on cash basis. A larger portion of the business is on credit basis. So when the goods are sold on credit, the seller may run into the nightmare and he may require some proof that he has sold the goods and he has to receive the money. So how it is done? After delivering the goods, he makes a letter. Let us now keep the term letter. Later on we will modify this word. He makes a letter asking the person to whom he has sold the goods that I have to receive from you after a specified period a certain amount of money, and you have to pay me that money. And he sends that letter to the buyer. The buyer accepts, if he feels, if he deems that this bill is okay, he accepts the bill and he returns it to the seller. On the acceptance of the bill, it becomes a bill of exchange. So in this chapter, we will learn to make the performa bills of exchange. Performa means the format of bills, of how a bill is drawn, how it is accepted. A 5-mark question come of the performa bills of exchange. We will learn to make general entries or general entries regarding how a bill is drawn, how it is accepted, and how a bill is disposed. The various treatment done of bills of exchange, the general entries are recorded. This chapter is also practical oriented, and every year 10 mark compulsory question come out of this chapter. Then the next chapter is company account. Company, joint stock company. You all know what is joint stock company. As in sole proprietor and partnership, what all a proprietor and a partner contribute, it is known as capital. You know that joint stock company needs a huge amount of money. Single person cannot, or group of person cannot contribute that huge amount of money. So a public at large contribute money, and a small denomination of the capital is known as share. A smallest denomination is known as share. It may be 1 rupee, 2 rupee, 5 rupee, 10 rupee, 15 rupee, 50 rupee, 100 rupee, 1000 rupees, and like that. Whatever the promoters and the management decide, in that denomination, the smallest unit of share is. Now, these shares are issued to the public, the money is received from that, and the accounting treatment of issue of shares we will learn in this chapter. This is also practical oriented. 10 mark question comes. It is in choice with dissolution. The next chapter is analysis of financial statement. Now, what is analysis? Analysis is studying a component of the final account. That is, a single component may be sale, purchases, wages, salary. So this is single component. And studying that component relationship with other figure or another amount, this is known as analysis. So let us understand with the help of an example. Suppose the amount of sale is 1 lakh rupees and the gross profit is 10,000 rupees. So there is a relationship between sales and gross profit, and the relationship is of, if 1 lakh rupee of sale is made, the gross profit is 10,000. So the relationship work out to be 10%. So with the help of various ratios, we understand the different component relationship. And for analysis of financial statement, different tools are there. Different tools, example, cash flow statement. Cash flow statement means from where the cash comes and from where the cash goes. Generally, objectives are asked from this chapter. Then the next chapter, the new introduction is computer in accounting. So what are the features of computer accounting? What are its advantage? What are the limitation? What are the importance? That all we will study in this chapter. Now we will study different accounting packages, in particular tally, how particular activities are done in this software or these accounting packages. So this was all about your syllabus, and your paper is of, as per past year, they were of 80 marks. For your help, I am showing you the past year paper. Just a minute, students. So this is your last year paper, with the paper which came in 2020, means this is your last year paper. For you, it is your last year paper. So you can have a look at this paper. In the next lecture, I will tell you the paper pattern in detail and how to attempt the paper. If you all have any doubts about the contents of the syllabus, you WhatsApp me in your group, and in the first, depending upon your queries, I will answer in the next lecture.
Thank you
so much, and please follow what all I told you in the beginning of the lecture. Thank you.